There's also the political side to this. If President Marcos Jr. doesn't do this now during his term, there's no assurance it will ever be done because you don't know who's going to win after 2028.
Yes, well, if President Marcos Jr. cannot get the gas and reed bank, then I will be the first to say that he's not competent. Why was Malaysia able to do it?
Yeah.
Why was Indonesia able to do it? We have the arbitral award. We have a mutual defense treaty with the U.S. and the U.S. is willing to go on a joint patrol with us. Why can't we get the gas? Why do these other countries, why are they able to get the gas?
Mm. So for you, this is the litmus test for President Marcos Jr. When it comes to the West Philippine Sea.
Yes, because at bottom, the battle over the exclusive economic zone is a battle of who can get the natural resources. Even if China does not recognize our EEZ, even if China does not recognize the arbitral award, as long as we get the gas, we are winning.
Mm. Okay. All right. Let's move on very quickly just to Ayungin Shoal. There's been talk of a different strategy. And of course, you do have the National Security Council saying there's no such thing as a new model, that new agreement when it comes to resupplying in Ayungin Shoal. But is it time we do things differently for Ayungin Shoal?
Well, first of all, we can explore other things.
Yeah, go ahead, Justice.
Well, we can explore other things like airdrops. Anything we can do as long as we don't concede our sovereign rights.
Is it time to actually put in another vessel to replace BRP Sierra Madre? Would that be too much of a statement? Is that too strong? Is that provocative?
Well, my suggestion, my recommendation is we put up a lighthouse and a marine research center because these are civilian activities. Mm. In the arbitral award of 2016, the tribunal refused to rule that the Chinese maneuvers constituted harassment because the U.S. the arbitral tribunal said these are military activities outside the jurisdiction of the arbitral tribunal. So what we should do is convert the activity to civilian. And if we put up a lighthouse and a Coast Guard substation there together with the Marine Research Center, that would be a civilian activity. If China stops us from putting those structures, we can go to the tribunal.
All right. Well, I think on that note, I don't want to keep you long, but I wanted to say that with all your points, clearly, if something needs to be done, then this is the administration to do it. If it's not done here, it's going to look bleak in the next few more years.
That's correct. We have no choice. We have to get the gas now. It takes 4 years to develop the gas field. And so there is really a gap. Malampaya will run out of gas. And we still cannot get the gas and reed bank because assuming we are still developing it. So we have to import LNG. Our power rates will go up, very expensive. But at least there is light at the end of the tunnel if we are already developing the reed bank as our next gas field.
All right. On that note, thank you very much for joining me today. Another informative interview. Former Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you to our viewers.